The red carpet can be an intimidating place.
Okay, come on, we're gonna keep walking, sir.
So grateful to be here and to see you.
Oh, it's Anthony Brown. What's going on, sir?
I try to make it now a place where I just share my heart.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I'm proud of you. Good to see you.
And hopefully sharing my heart is enough for people, you know?
Take care, G.
Music has been like the center focus for me to kind of like express myself all of my life. I was a 3-year-old little toddler and we were walking by a music store and they were playing Pachelbel's Canon. And as a 3-year-old, I walked up to the piano, as tall as I was, and you know, plucked out the notes. And my parents were like looking at me in a, such a strange way that it made me burst into tears because I said, what did I do wrong? But it actually was the beginning of this amazing journey. This amazing journey. I literally, you know, get a mic on, walk out on stage and say, Lord, whatever you have for me to give to these people, give it to me. And then I trust that when it's over, you'll give it back.
You thought I was worth saving.
That's my balancing act. Get on stage and give out all that I have and then leave off stage and allow God to refresh me and give me back what I poured out. I was 3 years old, now I'm 3 times. And it's still my thing. It still gets me through day to day.
I told all my friends at St. Jude that they could hang out with us. Yay! At okay. The concert and behind the scenes.
Yeah. Okay,
so
cool.
Y'all should say hi to them at least, because they're like,
hey, y'all!
They're awkward. They're like over my shoulder right now.
My group is called Group Therapy. It literally is a therapy session, because there I say to them, how are you doing? And they say, this is actually how I'm feeling. And we talk about it and we address it. And God gives me songs in it and we hold hands and we pray. And from those moments, it's therapeutic.
Work was admitting to myself and my therapist that I had issues and battles with depression. That was work. Wow. The Christian part of me says, okay, well, just name it and claim it and go up to the altar and just have prayer and that's cool.
Mm-hmm. That's
but now
talk.
The work part for me is to ascribe to the fact that I couldn't have a therapist and Jesus and it's okay.
There's a lot of negativity that's surrounded mental health. You know, people hear that and they immediately put a stigma on it. And for me, as a believer, as a Christian, to talk about mental health was such a big deal. You know, when I first started talking about it, people were like, but you're a Christian. Yeah, I'm a Christian. I'm also somebody who has feelings. And those feelings deserve to be addressed, and it's up to me to talk about them and deal with them. My faith absolutely gives me the tools that I need to be able to address it. When you're ill, you can have faith, and your faith will mentally prepare you to deal with the battle, emotionally help you deal with the battle, but you still go to the doctor.
Because we're not the only ones. No. There are people all over the world.
And so if you're dealing with something like a mental breakdown or a blockage or an emotional issue or depression like me, you can have your faith that will help you and sustain you and build you, but you can also go see a therapist so that you can talk out the root of the issue. My dad always tells me a bit of practical and a bit of spiritual. You need both for your miracle. You need both. My first red carpet experience was terrifying. I am an extreme introvert. I do not like meeting new people. I am very shy. And I remember being on that red carpet the first time, and it's all these cameras, and I'm like, this is making me nervous. And then got to the very end of the carpet, and waiting for me at the end of the carpet was a beautiful young lady with a St. Jude pin on.
What are you mostly looking forward to tonight?
What am I most looking forward to? I think it just happened. I was most looking forward to meeting you.
She changed everything for me. In fact, so much so that I started running to the red carpets at future events just to get to the end so I could get to my St. Jude interview. Those kids would be on that carpet with so much personality and bright smiles, and they would take all of the fear for me away. And I've had some really tumultuous situations that I've experienced in my life, but I don't think anything affected me as deeply as my first visit to St. Jude. And every time I go, even still, I go preparing for some new level of emotional change. Every time I go, we were walking around seeing families and children who were facing very adult situations. The way that some of them processed it for me messed me up, because I want to sympathize with them
And to see the joy and the light and the hope in some of their eyes, it made me say, wait a minute, I'm missing this. Because as an adult, something happens to me and I'm falling apart. And these kids are facing real world situations, and they have so much hope and so much joy, and they're surrounded by that. St. Jude taught me a lot about that village of people around you. If they all had a little faith and a little hope and a little joy, that does so much for your healing process. I just believe that there's like a special little thing that God does right over St. Jude. So I remember when I met this particular young person there. He happened to be a teenager. He took to me, and we took to each other. I remember the day that one of the members of the staff called me because they knew our relationship and told me that he had transitioned. And as a person of faith, it really, really made me struggle. I'm sorry. Because I just wanted a different outcome for him and for his family. And when I got that message, it really rocked me to the core.
I'm honored to introduce Anthony Brown and group therapy.
And all my winners at St. Jude. I love you.
This one particular young lady, she was a teenager too. I actually asked the hospital, could she come with me on the Devil Wars? I could feature her on one of my performances of a song.
Everybody makes a noise for patience. They can't stop you. They can't stop you. No, they can't stop you. They can't stop you. No. Make some noise.
We stood there and we danced together, and it just, it's the highs and lows of life. It just, it's a balancing act. It never ends.
So, anything going on, particularly that you want to talk about to St. Jude, the families of St. Jude, the people at St. Jude, anything you want them to know?
I love you. God loves you. Anthony's my brother. He loves you.
We love you.
St. Jude
is my passion project.
I love St. Jude.
Music is a universal language. It touches everybody, no matter what language you speak, no matter what demographic you are, no matter where you come from. Music has the ability to touch people from a deep place. And so I'm very aware right now of what my purpose is, what my passion is. And so it helps me to center my life in a way where I spend less time on the outskirts of my life and more time doing what I am here to do, which is why I'm so grateful to have this moment with you and to share with you guys about St. Jude, because that's part of my life's purpose. I'm more aware of it now than I ever have been before.